Okay, friends, subscribers, and all you YouTubers out there, I have just found something quite weird. Now, especially to something that I know for a fact is the thyroid. In my reality, the thyroid glands, and mind you, I'm saying glands plural, were actually up under here. Right, they would have stopped poisons if you had got bitten by a snake or something like that. It was natural body design that sort of saved your life, i.e., the thyroid glands were here for that reason, so the pretty much no poisons would come up here. That was the theory anyhow, and it was quite weird. Because thyroid glands were down here. I know that for a fact because my sister had a thyroid operation, had one of them removed. And because she had cancer in the thyroid gland and she had an operation under here. To this day, I don't know, I haven't checked that out with her yet in this reality because she used to have to wear a special one of those tightening sleeves that go over her arm to stop her arm from swelling because she had a thyroid gland removed. So yeah, that's a major difference. That's a shift of an organ again. Like these are shifted. These should be down here, under the rib cage, i.e. the kidney punch. There's some medicos that have been telling me some other organs are out of place. Like, I knew pretty much the basics. I knew where the thyroids were because my sister had an operation on them. I knew where the spleen was because a mate had an operation on his spleen. And I'm just trying to find the spleen now because the spleen is in a different spot. I actually had it. As you can see, I've been going over the anatomy, something shocking. Here we go. Here. See where the spleen is? Over the back. In my reality, the spleen was up here near the heart because when my mate had his spleen, he had damaged his spleen, they had to cut him open in the middle of the chest, in the sternum, and remove his spleen. It was just as dangerous as having a heart operation. By the way, your appendix looks different. And I think it's actually even in the wrong spot. But definitely the kidneys are in the wrong spot because you have your kidneys here in the lungs. See, in the rib cage, up in the rib cage. If you got punched in the kidneys, yeah, it wouldn't hurt you guys. It sort of would have killed us if it was a big enough punch. Everybody's got weaknesses, and that was one of ours. Yeah, so your organs are all over the place, but it's the size of the liver structure. I've noticed that too. I've been looking at the pelvis. The pelvis looks a different shape altogether. It's too high. The pelvis is too high. It's far too high. Yes, God, they really are. Definite anatomy into anatomy here. But the kidneys are too high. That is far too high for the right and left kidney. Anybody from my world knows for a fact that is not where the kidneys belong. That is pretty much up under the thing. That's not where the spleen was. The spleen was over here in the middle, in between the heart and the lungs. And it was at its own little spot, but now it's off to the side. Whether or not we are clones, I don't know, guys. I really don't know anymore what the hell is going on. And it's just really strange that everything here is way different. And I mean, it's way different. Just everything is in the wrong spot. See, that's your rib cage there. Your kidneys are up in your rib cage. Shouldn't be up in your rib cage. Everything, your lungs are just far too small. And it's a joke. It's sort of like, how do you breathe? How do we breathe? Because we now have that same anatomy. There was someone made a comment that they've tested the oxygen. They've got the ability to do that. A scientist, I'm now trying to get in contact with that person again to see if they can run a few other tests for me. But yeah, it's just everything is in the wrong spot. Your lungs are just way too small compared to our lungs, and your kidneys are definitely wrong spot. Liver, definite wrong spot. I was just trying to kill time before I went to tech. But yeah, check it out. That liver is just way too huge. It's in the wrong, pretty much there. The stomach, or in this image, looks like the stomach's actually in the almost in the right spot. But the lung capacity is too small. That's far too small. It sort of, for my reality, that is way, way too small. But here, the lungs, just way too small. I'm sorry, but whether you've got a different lung structure than we had, and we've come across, and we now have that same lung structure, because I've had an x-ray, and yeah, guys, unfortunately, our lungs now look as small as theirs. And it's quite freaky. And to actually go through, but it's the position of the spleen, but it was when I found that image of the thyroid glands. The thyroid glands are in the wrong spot. Thyroid glands are under the arms. Right, we had another similar gland up on, in here as well, down in there, similar to the thyroid. I think it might have even been a thyroid. And pretty much it would stop anything in your lower limbs, i.e. if you got gangrene, it was to help stop the it spreading up into your body. And they were what I was taught anyhow, because I know my grandmother, who passed away from gangrene, right, the only thing that kept her alive longer than the thing was the thyroid gland, but she was in a hell of a lot of pain, and she just eventually let herself go. But without the gland, I'm sure it was called a thyroid gland as well. It was a gland. There was something under the, in the groin area that stopped poisons coming up into this area. It was, we protected this area, something shocking, the way our natural design was. Our body was designed to protect this area and this area. These areas were considered, yeah, pretty much useless in the way the anatomy was designed. But I know for a fact, when my sister had her thyroid out, her operation was here. And she had to wear a sleeve in a over her arm. And I've actually got to check it with that. I've actually got to talk to her about her thyroid operation. So yeah, it sort of spun out a bit, and that's pretty much what my x-ray now looks like, and I can't move the damn thing. But it does have that extra bone up here in my x-ray as well. It's quite spun out there. The body of the sternum, see? That's a bone, see? Costal cartilages. Costal margin. Okay, that's cartilage. You had cartilage, yes, but then you have this. But it's this rib bone that you have. We didn't have. We did not have that rib bone so high, and we didn't have this jugular thing. These here went straight down and joined our rib cage down here. And that's the way we were designed in our reality. And I've got to say it, our reality. Because too many people are freaking out, yeah, i.e. the bone structure, I thought the way that image would come up. Actually, yeah, I can get that back into the shot. I forgot all about that, folks. I've already set that up. Yeah, so these extra little bones on ours would have been a bit shorter than that. Just way too much. This is all fused, where in ours it wasn't fused. The whole structure, yeah, there it is. You can just see that little bone, and it is a bone. It is a bone in the rib cage, and we didn't have a bone on the rib cage. The sternum in this reality is bone. In my reality, is hey, there we go. In my reality, that was my, that is our structure of everything. It's the layout of our kidneys, the layout of our stomach, the layout of our liver, and the layout of our rib cage. I.e., they used to be able to cut straight through our sternum, operate, they could remove a lung, they could do a heart transplant. Yeah, it was quite easy for him. So yeah, it's sort of quite weird what's going on. But it was the thyroid gland this morning. I just thought I'll have another look at the image because I wanted to take some stuff to TAFE with me and show the guys. I'm going to get him, see if I can get him to give me a hand working on a bit of stuff. But yeah, I was looking at all this stuff here and just thinking, this changes even in here. The structure of the liver looks different. But it's the positioning of it, the lungs, everything. Is the structure of your lungs are different. They do look more efficient. Yeah, I'm going to say that, guys. Their lungs look more efficient. They have to be. Look how fucking small they are. Their lungs have got to be more efficient. And as I said, someone sent me a letter saying that the oxygen contents and everything are different. And, okay, this is a front and a back view of it, I think. Yeah, it looks like a front and a back view of it. I don't know. But your lungs, if that's a front and a back view, your lungs are even shaped differently to ours. Yeah. Well, if we saw a picture in our reality, we'd see that. That's how it explained our lungs. It sort of, but there was more to it. There was definitely more to it. This, yeah, that's just not, it's too small. It's too small. That's too big. It's far too big. The appendix just sits there, and I think that's in the wrong spot. Any medios out there that have jumped, is that in the wrong spot? I think it is. My biology was good, but it's sort of out of place. But the positioning of the spleen is wrong. Spleen was up in here, middle of the chest, in my reality, because I know, because when they cut my mate open, they cut him down the sternum, took his spleen out. It's quite strange. Quite strange, quite strange. Here's another one, not big enough. Not big enough, sorry guys. Just buzzing through. Hey, look at this. Another of the t-shirts. They're really into anatomy t-shirts. This is weird. In our reality, we wouldn't wear something like that on our chest. We'd make people fucking sick. It's sort of as if they're trying to say to us, I'm beginning to now start to think maybe we could have been abducted. Maybe we could have been cloned. And these are little things trying to make us think that we belong here because we've got t-shirts and everything. They've watched too many fucking Halloween shirt copies, movies and things like that, or they've come down on fucking Halloween. It's just too fucking different. Too fucking different. It's just weird as hell. And I've got to say it, I apologise, ladies, for swearing. I'm just spun out by this again. I'm finding all these changes over and over. I'm finding definite differences. Definite differences that are freaking the hell out of me. And I'm sorry for swearing, ladies. I really am. But what other response can I give when I see something weird to what I know? I had to study this in school. And it's not misremembering. Like operations that I've had. Operations that friends have had. And it's just weird. It's just the positioning of the lungs. They cut off there. They should come all the way down. It's not right. It's just not right. Your lungs are too small. Your liver is too large. This is weird as all shite. Sorry, but it is. It's weird. It's weird. Sorry, guys. I've got to sniffle again. But, it was when I saw that thyroid gland. Now I can't find it. Yeah, because our thyroid was under our arm. It was part of here. See how it comes up here into... Looks like that's where it's coming into. These are coming into the thyroid. Well, our thyroid was under here. Sorry, but it was. I know for a fact it was. Spleen, wrong place. Oh, sorry, lymph nodes. Okay, lymph nodes again. Okay, lymph nodes. That's what I was thinking of, lymph nodes. They're the ones, we had lymph nodes under our leg. Again, they're in the wrong spot. They're in the wrong spot. They've got lymph nodes in your neck. Okay, this is definitely not our anatomy. There is no friggin' way. This is the human anatomy that I remember. Thyroid is up. Oh, on this one it's saying the thyroid's up in the neck. Okay, your trachea is in the right spot. Well, if my sister's operation, thyroid operation, cut her under the arm, they would have had to put her fucking their arms all the way up into a fucking neck to pull out a thyroid. Yeah, really? I don't fucking think so. I'm sorry, ladies, I'm swearing because, yeah, I'm spun out again. I'm spun out again. Something shocking. This is freaky. This is too freaky for me. It's just wrong. Just way, way wrong. And why would someone wear a t-shirt with... Where is the t-shirt? Let's find that t-shirt again. Why would someone wear a t-shirt with the human anatomy on the front? You'd either be called one of two things. A freak or a nerd. A major nerd. To wear something like that, you'd have to be a major nerd. Okay? In my reality, you... Like, I'm a nerd, but that'd be major nerd. Only a major nerd would wear something like that. Or it was a Halloween costume. Like the bones. Okay, let's go. Human anatomy t-shirts. Let's do a new search. Let's see what there is. Okay? I never, ever thought of doing human anatomy t-shirt search. Because... I bet you we find them. Yep. There we go. There we go, folks. Yeah, look at this. Check this out. They're big into these t-shirts. Old worlders, we never saw shirts like this anywhere. We saw a skull shirt because it was tough. That was it. Oh, you might have seen something like this where a doctor wanted to show off he was a doctor. But this... This, same guy. Check this out. It's the same guy. Maybe we have been abducted, guys. Check it out. It's the same guy. Okay. That's the same guy, but with the shave. Yeah. It's still the same guy. Just had a shave in that one. Arms the same. Yeah, wow. See? Okay, we've been abducted there, and they've watched too many Halloween fucking movies. Or we are in a total thing. See, this was more like it in our reality. Skulls. But human anatomy t-shirts? Man, they've watched too many fucking Halloween movies. This is what it is. They've watched too many friggin' Halloween movies. Yeah, because we had shirts and shit like that only on Halloween. Only one night a year. Okay, that's a cool tattoo. Right, okay, that one I've got to say is a cool tattoo. Yeah, okay, yeah, you see, it's all human anatomy tattoos. That was about it. This is weird. Yeah, see, picture of a skull is way different to the pictures of skulls that we had. Sleeping bags, human anatomy sleeping bags, lungs, brains. Okay, guys from my reality, you're as spun out as me, I know you are. You are now as freaked out and as spun out as me, because these guys, I'm now beginning to think, yeah, okay, we're either clones, and they think that this is how we were, because they might have abducted someone on... Okay, what in the fuck is Spock doing with a character from Futurama? What the fuck? Dr. Zoidberg? Okay, there's definitely a crossover there. Yeah, but this sort of shit, man. Okay, yeah, you can understand doctors wearing them, but this to me, Anatomy Park? Okay, that's a search I've just got to fucking do. Sorry, I've got to do a search. And, yeah, okay, Anatomy Park. I should be fucking... I'm sorry, lady. I've done it again. I'm sorry. I'm just spun out again. Anatomy Park. Holy shit. Rick and Morty? Okay, let's have a look. What a fuck are Rick and Morty? Something strange in the neighborhood, guys. We are not in Kansas anymore. Toto, we definitely ain't in Kansas anymore. Okay, we need to go to a movie thing. One that searches really well, which would be this one. Rick and Morty, Anatomy Park. Let's have a watch. We might be watching a cartoon. Rick and Morty. Rick and Morty. I just want to see if it exists. Nah. Caps lock is on. Rick. Let's see if it exists. Okay, guys, you might be going and watching a cartoon. Nah, no search there. Ah, whoa. That should be searching. This search engine never failed in the past. Hang on. Let's go back to Anatomy Park. Let's search that. Anatomy Park. L-I-M-O-G. Oh, it exists. Put locker. There we go. See if it comes up. I'm not going to, for legal reasons, folks, I'm not going to show this, but it does. Rick and Morty, Anatomy Park. Yep. So, for legal reasons, I can't show it, as you know. So, yeah, this, yeah, is weird. It's really, 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 really weird. So, I don't know what's going on, folks. It's sort of, I don't know. Are we in an alternate reality? Are we abductees? Are we being shifted in time? Are we... Yeah. Question after question after question after question. At the moment, I'm a bit spun out because of all this. These T-shirts alone. See, this is what I'm used to. Yeah, we had a lot of skulls. Skulls were a big thing. Yeah, skulls. They were big on T-shirts in my reality. Brains? No. Ribs? No. That sort of thing. Yeah, that was everywhere. And gothic. Yeah. Or demonic. Yeah, but this? Yes, that would have passed. You might have seen a rabbit or two. You might have seen that. That would have been a cool-looking T-shirt. But this? Why would you put this on your T-shirt? Why would you want to wear that? See, yeah, you might see a skeleton like that, but not like the where it fits over the body. The only time you saw that, and that's a different T-shirt to what he wore in our movie. In our movie, he wore a different T-shirt. Yeah. Oh, can anybody remember what he wore in The Hangover in our movie? Yeah, because it wasn't that, that's for sure. I know that, just looking at it. Yeah, see, that would have been our world. But, yeah, they've watched too many fucking Halloween movies, I'm sorry. I've got to say it, they have. They've abducted us and they've watched too many fucking movies. They've seen too many Halloween, because, yeah, Halloween movies are big. And they've seen too many movies. It's weird as nothing else. So you've got to turn around and you've got to look and you've got to find stuff. Go out and do some searching, folks. As I said, I hope you're still exploring, right? Because you'd be mad if you did not explore. Because we are in a different reality, and guess what? Don't buy souvenirs because you're not going to be able to take them home. And don't send the poor person's bank account that you're in broke. Because he might be doing the same thing to you, but I don't think he's smart enough. He's got to realise he's living in that world. If you send this person broke, you might be stuck here for the rest of your life. So if I was you, I'd be increasing their bank accounts. So yeah, don't be stupid and go out and spend all your money thinking you're only going to be here for a little while. You could be here for the rest of your life. So yeah, that would have made it into our world. But, see, that looks, it's a Halloween, and sort of, but they've made shit here. The human plates are different. Okay, that's different in this world. The skull around it's missing. That was in our world, but we had a skull around it. It represented some military group. Yeah, it's so, so different, folks. It's so, so different, yeah. Why would you wear a piece of clothing like that? This is... Okay, I've got to go back to that abduction theory. I'm sorry, after seeing this, I've got to go to it. I had no choice. Maybe we have been abducted. Maybe we have been a clone. See, this is what we used to wear. Is these sort of clothing at Halloween. At only Halloween. And it just seems strange that now there's t-shirts like that. Yeah, it's really, really freaky, guys. It's really, really freaky. I don't know what to do anymore. Oh, I'm in a bit of a turmoil. I'm shocked. I'm thinking. But okay, everybody go and put Locker, Rick and Morty, Season 1, Episode 3, Anatomy Park. Check it out because I don't ever remember that cartoon. Oh, would I have watched Rick and Morty? I never remember Anatomy Park. But, yeah. Everything's wrong. Everything's wrong. Nothing's right. I'm sorry, but nothing's right. This ain't our world. And it ain't our world. I'm sorry to say it isn't our world. Like, my son, when I was looking at my son at the march outparade, I was looking at his skull because it was so predominant, those indentations that look like Neelix. Because that reminds me, that skull there reminds me of Neelix out of Star Trek, because he had those indentations. My son had those indentations in the side of his head. Whether or not that it was the same, my same son or whatever, but I'm going to embrace him as my own. Check this out. Okay, now this looks weird. This, why would you emphasize the difference in the sternum? Okay, why would you emphasize that? I'm going to move that across. Why would you emphasize that? Notice that? Notice the difference here. Why would you emphasize this difference unless you know that that's deliberately different and you're just showing off? Look at it, folks. Why emphasize this difference? Okay, this is a big question, okay? Why have they done that? Okay, why is that particular difference in the rib cage being shown as being real? Okay, why is that there? Why is it like that? Why is it being shown as being a different colour? When the sternum's bone in this reality, the ribs are bone, right? The differences in our reality is that. That's the difference of the human rib cage in our reality. It's the same as the kidney t-shirts and everything like that one, right? That one there. Showing the differences in between us and them, whether or not that's how they tell each other, oh, I'm like you, you're one of me, and this is us, where this is us. So this is our ribcage, that's their ribcage. So why emphasize, this is a serious question. Why are they emphasizing human anatomy so much on t-shirts and everything? How many of us did they take? How many of us did they clone? This is really, really strange, folks. It's sort of, this now adds more oomph to the mystery. Just that one picture adds oomph to the mystery. Why is this change in the anatomy spelled out on a t-shirt? Big question. Major change to our anatomy is spelled out in a t-shirt. Is this some kind of a bug that attached itself to our ribcage, right? Or is this a change? And they're showing us that this is a bug. Have we been taken over? Have they physically remodeled our Earth? But I don't think it is. I think we've been shifted, but it's this that freaks me out. Okay, this has now freaked me out more than anything, more than the loss of my kids, everything, because why is this emphasized? Why would you emphasize cartilage and a bone change on a t-shirt? Okay, old earthers, think about it. Why would they do that? Why would they turn around and make these changes here from this to this and then stick it on a t-shirt? Why are they advertising anatomy on t-shirts and things like that? Unless they're trying to show the differences of what's going on. And it's strange, like, yeah, t-shirts that have anatomy on them. I'm just going to run through them again. Zoohooster? Wasn't it Zoolander? Okay, that's weird. It's supposed to be Zoolander. That's he wasn't in Zoolander. But it's all these friggin' weird t-shirts. And actually, t-shirts have been spinning me out since day one. Okay, that's our world. You'd say our world. So notice they're emphasizing the skull on the side. Most of our skull views are always forward. Again, emphasizing the change. This is why it's been freaking me out. See, that now world would have been normal. A t-shirt like that would have just been normal. No one would have second looked twice at it. But you've got to notice here, again, buttons. Buttons with human anatomy on them. The changes to the human anatomy. There must be a change in the brain somewhere because they're emphasizing the brain. I've actually noticed a lot of brain pictures too. But here, again, skull pictures to the side. They're emphasizing this change. And here, skull. Notice here, they've got little points on the side of their skull. That would have just gone round on our skulls. Here, bags, emphasizing the side of the skull. It's really, really, really weird, folks. Something is not right. Houston. We have a problem. We ain't in Texas anymore. See, again, skull t-shirts, emphasis to the side, emphasis to here. Body shirts, skeleton, full skeletons, all about the change. It's about the changes. Even the Da Vinci, actually, yeah, there's a good one. The Da Vinci photo's not right. The legs were wider. And the other arms were higher. Okay, so that's different. Okay, so that's something. The anatomy changes showing up in t-shirts. Kids wearing skull t-shirts. Like, not skulls. See the brain. Okay, there's a difference in the brain. Got to find out what that is. I'm going to have to study that now. But here, they're emphasising the change. Notice here, okay, emphasis on the bloody differences in the skull. On a pillow? Holy fuck, nightmare fucking city. The pelvis, okay, yeah, as I said, there were changes in the pelvis, in the coccyx, in this area. The changes, this is too high. Ours is more flattened. All the changes of the anatomy. See, again, they spelled out this change in the T-shirt. They've made it noticeable. They've made it noticeable. And they've made the lungs, okay? Why, okay, the lungs. Made the lungs small. They've put it on a T-shirt. As if to try and indoctrinate us to say this is the way it should be, when we know it's not the way it should be. We could have been abducted. We could have been cloned, but our memories came across and everything. Yeah, folks, yeah. Emphasising the change. Emphasising the change. There's differences. Okay, the six-pack is a bit different. It's a lot. Yeah, that's a lot higher. The six-pack is different. Yeah, here. Ah, check this out. Before and after. That's different. Very different. Sorry, folks, I'm going a bit quiet here, but I'm just getting spun out by all these. They're emphasising the changes in the anatomy. They're showing it. Showing the smaller lungs. Showing the bigger liver, the smaller lungs. Why would you put those on a T-shirt if it wasn't for the fact that they're trying to sort of say, okay, well, this is how it should look when we know it looks like this. Yeah, something's not right in the state of Georgia, folks. Houston, we have a problem. We want to fucking go home. Yeah, we want our world back. We want to go back to our world. Yeah, I do. I don't care about anybody else. I may be a rough tut nutter, but no, rough nut tutter, tougher. I can't even say it. Sorry, I don't have my teeth in at the moment. That's the same. Pity. I would have loved to have my teeth in this reality. I still lost them in this reality. I haven't found out how I lost them in this reality. Lost them in with a horse throwing me on a pole in my reality. Yeah, I got bucked off while I was breaking a horse in, and got thrown up onto a bloody pole on the ring, and knocked all my teeth out. It wasn't too nice. But here, that does not belong. This is a little bit higher. Our ribcage would have came to about here. And ours was all cartilage. But it's those T-shirts that are freaky. They're too freaky for me. They are not right. Human anatomy being spelled out on T-shirts. Things that look like it came from Halloween. Emphasis on the changes. Emphasis on the changes. And I mean major emphasis on the changes. It's sort of not just little things they're trying to emphasize. They're emphasizing the major change, trying to find that one T-shirt again. But it's weird. It's wrong. The whole anatomy is wrong. The Bible's wrong. Everything is wrong. The land masses are wrong. My local harbour is wrong. They could have done some better study if they were, but yeah, this is too friggin' freaky. Emphasis on all the changes. There it is. But it's that one T-shirt there. It's that one T-shirt that is freaking me out. Oh, shit, I've lost it. Sorry, guys. When I shrunk it, I lost it. I've got to find it again. But, yeah, it's that one T-shirt that emphasised the change in the ribcage. To me, why would you emphasise that change? Why? Why need? Why is the need to emphasise that part of the ribcage on a T-shirt? Okay? There's no other reason. I've got to find this again. Sorry, guys. Shrunk it and I lost it. Why would you need to emphasise that change? Why would you need to? It's just doesn't make sense. Unless they're trying to make us think and indoctrinate us that that is part of our anatomy. Maybe these t-shirts are magically appearing. Like here, a skull t-shirt. The skull is in the wrong way. It's more emphasis on the change in the side of the head. All the skull pictures. Look here, see, they've got this little bit, that bone that comes out. Our skull came around there like that, always. Even in our scalp, every skull picture came around like that. Where the hell is that shirt? So, yeah, the changes are being emphasized in t-shirts. That's what's got me. It's been emphasized. Okay, what's going on here? It's vanished. Couldn't have vanished, folks. It was just there. Everybody saw it. It's in the video. Everybody saw that bloody t-shirt. I'm not scanning too fast. I might have been. You can tell me I scanned too fast past or I missed it. But I'm going to go slow. Why is it vanished? Well, okay, there it is there. Okay, there it is there. Okay, it's not the same picture, but it does still do the same thing. It emphasizes the change in the reality. Emphasizing the change in the reality. Why would you need to do it? Even our skull and guns has been changed. This one has got that lump, and that lump is that bone, extra bone. These here, they're emphasizing the physical changes in the anatomy. Why do they need to do that? They don't. Why would you need to emphasize that particular change? I've got to upload this one, guys, so I love you all, hope you're coping. As I said, I'm going to go through this, spill every video that I've got, embrace the world around you, because we are now dimension travellers, whether we like it or not. We are being shuffled in into new dimension. Enjoy it, learn about it, learn about this reality, take it back to your world so you can tell people what you've gone through. You might find that when next time they turn over CERN, we may wind up in another different one. Document everything. Leave a note for your predecessor. Leave a note so that he knows why, what you did, why you were here, so that he can keep up and not think that he's nuts. Look after yourself, okay? Now, I'm going to emphasize this. Look after yourself, and I'm talking about our alternate selves, okay? Leave notes for them, so that they know that when they've been shuffled back in this reality, that they know that something weird has happened, what you have done while you were here. Help them out. And if they're anything like you, they're going to be doing the same. And if my predecessor is anything like me, he's going to be doing the same in the other reality. Expect changes when you go home. Look at them before you question it. And people say, oh, why'd you do this? Why'd you do that? Think about what you say before you say it. Tell them that, yes, you were shifted. Tell them to research the Mandela effect. Check the Mandela effect out while you're there. See how far the Mandela Society has gotten. And, yes, I know I'm still having dramas with them. And I'm not going to tell you the dramas I'm having now with the website. It's quite strange. But, I'm having a few picture problems getting it up, and other little things are happening, and it's as if I'm being prevented from getting this website started. I'm really, really sorry. There's changes in my favourite game, major changes in this game here, the Citadel. Even these pictures are different. So, the thing is, folks, it's, just too weird for me. And I mean, it's just too weird. You've got to turn around, you've got to make it so that you can show everybody the changes that you have experienced, so that you can say, okay, yeah, well, I went through this, went through that. But leave a note somewhere where your predecessor can find it, somewhere where you know that he was all the time, because you would have noticed things in the thing. Like differences, my office desk is covered in tools in this reality. But in other words, he's always here, and he's got computer monitors everywhere, so I'm sticking a dirty big note up on one of the monitors saying, look at this file, I've done a special video just for him, telling him of the changes and different differences, and do something like that so that they know they're not going nuts, okay? they've got it. You've got to help them out, because when they come home, yeah, I'm trying to help mine get the invention on the market, where in my reality it was on the market. So yeah, you've got to try and do things to help it out. Don't go out thinking, oh, I'm going to spend all my money, because, as I said, you are the one that could be stuck here for the rest of your life. So don't go and do something stupid. Okay, look after yourselves, embrace the ones around you, love the ones around you, and embrace them as your own, because in this reality, they are your own. Your kids are still okay if you're in the same boat as me. The only way you can look at it is if your children are still okay. Okay, they are in another reality. You're still there with them, but it's just not you. It's the person either from this reality or a different reality. Everything's been switched around. Or whether we have just been all merged together, we don't know. But all I can say is, look after yourselves, guys. Hold on, hold fast to what you have. Okay? If you're having it tough, talk to one of us. Talk between each other. You are the only support. We are the only support we really have in this world. So stick together, guys, and look after yourselves, okay? Sorry for spinning out again, but I'm just finding these changes left, right, and center. And I'm going to update you on them as I find them. So look after yourselves. I'm seeing that sort of, and those are the flat earthers that have been contacting me lately. Look, don't stress out. Your world is flat, okay? I understand that. But our world wasn't flat. That's what you've got to understand. And so just understand that, yes, we believe that the globe is round because we know the globe was round. It was a globe. Satellite images from different things. And in my reality, yes, the moon landing was faked. But satellites weren't. And I've seen the live footage of the International Space Station showing us everything like that of the Earth. And yeah, but here we go. Flat earthers. Yeah, don't freak out. Don't hassle the round earthers too much, because okay, your earth is flat. Just accept the fact you're in a round earth again. Okay, you've been moved in reality. That's what the problem is. You have shifted, because if you harass any of the round earthers, I will bar you from this channel. I'm sorry, but I will. I moderate this channel for a reason. This is for us, so that we can support it. It used to be so I could put my research out, and it's turned into, yeah, a support channel. Well, I'd sooner have a support channel, because I need the support as well. I need you guys, and you guys need me, and everybody needs each other. So, look, we are now a family, whether we like it or not. So, yeah, be nice to each other, okay? All right. Pop a smurf out. See ya.